So we were learning the sicha, first sicha for Parshas Shlach and Chelam Chol Gimel. It's a short sicha, easy sicha, but a special heiroa, which is a very important heiroa, even though the sicha is not long, and it is a very easy sicha. And this is something that Rebbe spoke about many times in different sichas. The one that's quoted here, that this came from sichas Parshas Shlach, Tov Shin Lamed Gimel, but this teichem was said by the Rebbe many times. In Pasuk Shlach Locha Anoshim, and the Pasuk in the beginning of the Parsha, where Hashem said to Moshe, Shlach Locha Anoshim, send to you, the Loshen is Locha Anoshim, send to you people, which means send the Meraglim, the spies. Zog Chazal, the Chazal say, this is in Gemara, and Asher brings it down. Shlach Locha means L'day Tocha, send to you, meaning L'day Tocha, according to your will, if you want to. And as Debesha said, I'm not telling you to send, send according to your opinion, if you decide to do it. And the shluch ha-meraglim is given uphanging and daita shal Meshe, the sending of the meraglim, but dependent on the opinion of Meshe. Oberani, eini mitzaveis, I'm not commanding you, Davisha said. Send it if you decide to do it. So the Rebbe says, dafen fashtein. Meshe Rabbeinu dan given an eved nemon, idoch given an eved nemon from Davisha. We know Meshe Rabbeinu was a eved nemon, he was a servant of Hashem. The word eved really doesn't mean a servant, it means really a slave of Hashem. The Rebbe says, "Nahora, look in Baleischa." It says, "Avdi b'Meisha." Meisha was the Eved of Deibishter. It says in different places also, Meisha is called the Eved Hashem, a servant of Deibishter, and not Stam a servant, but the Eved Nemon, a trustworthy servant. Is the Fumfashtanik? From that we understand that Dos was Daitish Shal Meisha is given to Shikin the Meraglim. That this, that Meisha's opinion was yes to send the Meraglim. He says the Farvas Azay is given to Daitish Shal Adonai, because that was the opinion of his master, for the Meibishten. Because even by a person, when you say a person is an Eved Neman of his Odin, of his master, that means his mind works what his master wants. That's called Eved Neman. He's completely given over to his master. So whatever he feels is because he knows that that's what his master wants. So in this case also, if Meshe was an Eved Neman from the Eibishter, so this is really the opinion of the Eibishter. When their posik is made, and the posik Taka testifies, Meisha sent him the gamer al pi Hashem, which means b'reshus shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu, according to Hashem, with the permission of Hashem, which means this was a right thing to do. Heistes adrinim for shluach ha-meraglim mitzad atzmei, that the fact of sending the meraglim in its own is a dover teverot. So it's a good thing. It's something that is acceptable. Something that is good to do. Umi the Ramban is mavayit. The Ramban taka explains why it was a good idea, as the derech harogil for nainim and alan. The normal way to conquer a land is durch schicken freie Meraglim zu gefinnen, was ist der beste und geringste Weg, lichtliches Oretz. To send first spies to figure out, to decide what's the best and easiest way to conquer the land. Und wir bald das ein same Kanal an this, since you shouldn't rely on miracles. Und man darf sich greiten mit dem Chomer bederich Hateve, and you have to, that's the right way to do it. Since you don't rely on miracles, you have to prepare yourself to fight the war in a natural way. But Meshe Rabbeinu masking event to shikin to Meraglim. So Meshe Rabbeinu agreed to send the Meraglim, because this is the right way to do it. Now, since Meshe agreed to this, means that this is the right way. Is nitfashtandik, you don't understand. Parvosa the Eibishter, the Svevli, and the Daita Shal Meshe. So why did Eibishter make this dependent on the opinion of Meshe? Unita leim lechatchila, ungezokt of them. Why didn't the lechatchila tell him send the Meraglim? If this is the right thing to do, the Eibishter should have told him to do it. Why is the Eibishter make it that if you decide to do it, then fine. But Bama Zebeshev wanted it to be done. So why didn't he tell him to do it? We also have to understand. The Negeya de Meraglim Zog Trasha, considering the Meraglim Rasha says, Eise Shok Sheirim Hoyu. At that time, when Meisha chose them and Meisha sent them, they were kosher, which means they were tzaddikim. And we understand the Gebe Sechel HaPosher, that's understood, kosher in simple logic. As if Meisha Rabbeinu Zalein is Yiklim, if Meisha Rabbeinu himself chose them, so they were obviously not just plain kosher people in tzaddikim. So the ambest that zugepasst for that dozik shlichus, the best people fit for this specific shlichus. If Meisha chose them, and Meisha definitely knew everyone, knew what's inside everyone, and if he chose them, obviously they were the best candidates for the shlichus. Is vikumtes, how is it possible that such a great change happened to them from one extreme to the other? Not only did they accomplish the shlichus, the mission, the way they're supposed to, those of them gebracht a fitn abchila deiras. They brought upon Yidden a bchila deiras. The expression bchila deiras means crying for generations. But this is an expression used in the Gemara. The Gemara says that when did this happen, that they came back and they scared the Eden and the Eden cried, was Tisha B'Av at night. And the Eved said, you are crying now for no reason. You have nothing to cry. There's nothing to be afraid of. This will, I'll make it that on this day, for later generations, there will be crying. So the crying that we have on Tisha B'Av, which is the Churban Beis HaMikdash, all came as a result of what the Meraglim did here. So it came out that the Meraglim, from being great tzaddik and the most people who are the most lishaycha to this mission, turned out the opposite, that this became abchil adeiros. All generations were suffering from this. How is it possible? First, to explain that we find that the shlich is the mission that the Eibish, that Meshra ben Ascend and Raglim contained, was made up of two parts, two inyonim. Number one, so is gifin and the protein vel chazain and the gate to them kibishoras, to figure out the details which are important for the conquering of the land. Like he said, we should see hachozok, is it strong or weak? Hamat, is it a lot of less people, more people? What's the population? Habemachnim, do they live in fortresses, cities with walls or not? These are all to see how we are able to conquer the land. Second thing was, so is gifin and the protein vel the land gufe. Other things were to find out details about the land itself. The Eibush told them we're taking Eretz Yisrael. Find out what kind of land is it. Hatevei, is it good or not good? Hashmeinei, is it fat or not fat? All the details. And the second part, which was to find out what is the quality of the land, was so important to their mission. As Meisha told them, make yourself strong. Put in effort and bring back from the fruit of the land. Why did they have to say this chazaktem? Put in effort. Why is this something that needed so much effort? So the Rebbe explains, by bringing the fruit of the land, that made put them into a danger. People would see them taking the fruit and walking with the fruit. Obviously, they saw them were Meraglim trying to bring something from the land. So it was a danger. Nevertheless, he said, Zonze von deswegen, Meshra Bina told him, nevertheless, sich starken und anstrengen und breken mit Peoritz. Strengthen yourself and put an effort and bring from the fruit of the land. That's so important because that will prove the quality of the land. Isn't it glottic? So we don't understand. It's not simple. Emes tak azeinu demeri yom nishmiya. Tak, it's not the same when you see something, look up hearing, when you hear about something and you believe it. And it's true in your mind, you know that's true. But if you see it yourself, it's much stronger. In the Rebbe, therefore, need cook and dika was the Rebbe Shurach and the Tzilt Eden as Eretz Yisrael as Eretz Tevur Chova. Eretz Ovas Cholvat Vosh. So in spite of the fact that the Rebbe Shurach told the Eden, this is going to be a big, a good land, a wide land, a land that of milk and honey. Un Eden zayin noch maminim b'nei maminim. And Eden are believers, children are believers. So they knew that it's true. They knew this is a Baltic land, the West land. Especially that in this case, the Eibush told him, and you believe what the Eibush said, they didn't even need a munna here. For sure, those people who lived in Egypt, knew what's going on in Israel. They knew, people knew from one place to another. So they probably heard it from other people also, that this is a special, special land. So they knew it. So why did they have to bring, why did the Eibush want, they should bring from the fruit? It doesn't come to seeing, because seeing is when you really, it really comes true in your mind. What would make them even happier had they seen the fruit? Like it says, they would go up, the Ramban says, they would go up with simcha, seeing the fruit. So it's much more. So the Eibushet wanted them to bring from, even though it means that they put themselves in danger. But that's a, nevertheless, the question is, is it that important? If they knew it anyway, and they believed it anyway, is it so important that they should see it themselves? So much, so important that it's worth to put themselves into danger. So why did they do it? So there's another kasha. So basically, we have three kashas here. One, why didn't they wish to command him to do it? If definitely it was a good idea. The second thing is, if they were such tzaddikim, how could it happen that within a short while, they went from one extreme to the other? And the third question is, why was it so important to bring the fruit? We understand, it was the Rebbe saying, we understand why it was a good thing to do, but so good that you have to go put yourself in danger for it, if they knew it anyway. Ain't it from the Biurim in them? So the Rebbe said, one of the explanations is like this. Hagama de Yisod Tzikim HaTeireh is Agdomes Naaseh L'Nishma. Even though the foundation of fulfilling the Torah is when you say Naaseh before Nishma. That you say, I will do, and then I will hear. Now, hearing doesn't mean hearing. Hearing means understanding. So the Yidin said to the Eibishter when he gave him the Torah, and this is the foundation of every Yid, the way you're supposed to approach the Torah, keeping the Torah, you say, I'm going to do. The first thing I'm going to do, Kabbalah say, you accept, will do. And then you say, I will understand. You don't wait to understand, and then you will do. You will do it before you understand. Afa pikein is nasale nitmasti. But you could ask a question, if the main thing is the doing without understanding, so why do we need a nishma at all? Why didn't he say, Naaseh, we'll do it, that's it. We won't even try to understand. Nevertheless, they need Naaseh before nishma. The foundation has to be the Naaseh. But you have to have the nishma too. After the Naaseh, after you say, I'm definitely going to do it no matter what, you have to have the nishma. What's nishma? Meloshon avonah, from the loshon of understanding. Kamei like the pasuk, Dabek ishamei avdecha, to speak because you're servant is listening. It didn't mean listening. Speak because your servant understands. So the word nishma means to understand. So after you accept upon yourself to do it, no matter what, then you have to also try to understand. The same thing is concerning this, that Hashem wanted them to go into Eretz Yisrael. The Eibishter told the Yidden that it's a good land and it's a wide land. The best, all the qualities are there. And that's it. The Eibishter said, you accept it. Oh, but the Eibishter will as Eden zon einzend them good Eretz Yisrael ei besich lamein. The Eibishter wants that they should see, recognize the goodness of Eretz Yisrael even with their seichel. In other words, the main thing taka is to accept. The Eibishter said, we know it's true and that's it. But the Eibishter wants an Ishma that they should also understand it with their own logic, with their own intellect. When the Eibishter Meisha Rabbeinu Gehesim bring him in Prihor, that's what Meisha said they should bring from the fruit of the land. Today, as the rotsu for Eden again, can Eretz Yisrael, so that the will of the Eden to go to Eretz Yisrael, Zol Zayin, should be neat nor valazeya the Eibishter Gehesim. Not only because Hashem said so, but Melech Folgu Zeidem Tzibri Hashem, the listening to Hashem, the Naaseh, we will do no matter what. Nor Eich Metzadzei Alein, the Eibishter wanted that this Naaseh should turn into Nishma. They should also on their own want to do it. Zei Fashteya Nemedar Velen Gein Kan Eretz Yisrael, they should understand, they will understand that they should want to go to Eretz Yisrael. Vazi is the Emes Eretz Tei Berchova. Because it's stuck as with, even in Gashmias, they understand that this is Eretz Tei Berchova. That's what the Eibishter wanted. So that's why I told him to bring, and it's important. But Meisha told him to do it, even though it meant putting himself in danger. Because it's very important that they themselves, with their own understanding, and by seeing it, it'll make them really, with their own seichel, see how Eretz Yisrael is good. That's concerning the second part of the shlichus, to see how good Eretz Yisrael is. So Meisha Rabbeinu wanted, this is what Eibishter's rotzon is, that they should understand it, and with their own seichel, how good Eretz Yisrael is, even if it means the sakone, bring the fruit, so you will, with your own seichel, see the greatness of Eretz Yisrael. The same thing in the first part. So they should find out how is the easiest way to conquer Eretz Yisrael. At the kavanah the bais given. What was the purpose? What was the kavanah? As Eden's on eins and besichlam v'yachol nufalo. They should see with their own seichel how they are able to conquer. In other words, besides the fact that Eibishter said you're able to, we accept Eibishter, but we don't see how. We don't know what. But they would do it anyway. The Eibishter wanted that they should, with their own seichel, come to this understanding of what the Eibishter wants. And that's the reason why the Eibishter did not command to send the Maraglim. Nor shlach lachod l'daitoch send it. You decide. Meisha should decide. And the question was, why? If it was a good thing to do, why didn't the Eibishter tell him to do it? Now I understand. Since the whole purpose of sending the Maraglim, as we just said, is that the Yidin should have also the Nishma, the Yidin should also understand the Maraglim will come back and tell them exactly how we were able to conquer it. So they will even, their own seichel, know that they will be able to conquer it. That's the Nishma. When they get to the Knees and Lords concerning the entering of Eretz Yisrael, so the sending itself came from something that they, on their own decide. Meisha Rabbeinu, on his own decide. Meisha Rabbeinu is also part of Klal Yisrael. The Eibishter wanted that the Yidden on their own should decide the right thing with the foundation of Naaseh, but you should also come to understand it. Your own understanding. That's what the Eibishter said. The right, the Eibishter didn't say this to Meisha, but this is the idea. The right thing is to send Meraglim. And if the Eibishter would command, Why would they do it? Because David Shah said so. David Shah wants you, you decide yourself. You come to this understanding of what I want. That's why he said, it has to also be that way because of your das. Not only you're doing it because I'm commanding you. That's why you do it on your own. Decide on your own. That's what Abisha made this one especially. It could be a decision from Meshe Rabbeinu because it's supposed to be that it should be Nishma, even though it's based on Nase. This will explain how the Meraglim, at that time they were tzaddik and they were kosher. From Gikent as they durchfallen, they could fall so low, that said, came to a decision that we can go. Even though David said you could, and they started out being tzaddikim. But this shows us how it's possible. Why? Since the whole union of shlichus is the nishma, the second part, the part that David wants us to understand on our own. So, to figure out the entering of Eretz Yisrael, to investigate how you enter the soul. Now that it's in the level of doing it with your seichel, or that even you can't by zeven, not to us, now they can make a mistake in their seichel. If it's from David, there's nothing to talk about. Who cares what you think? You himself wouldn't care. But now that they were told you have to do this something that your seichel will be involved, so now sometimes you can make a mistake. From also the Meraglim Gizok, the Gneret Yisrael, everything the Meraglim said concerning Eretz Yisrael, the Gneret Yisrael, Yeshua concerning Eretz Yisrael, and the people who live there, Asom, they said they're strong. Completely Anok, we saw the giants there. He's not given them, which is all true. And also their maskone, their when they came to bottom line, as leinu chalalis, that will not be able to do it. Al piteve kemeni tevis on the soul. That naturally there's no way we conquer the soul. Chot anot neseichel. That makes sense. It makes sense because the way they saw it, and they were supposed to come back that to show that they al piteve are able to conquer it. We understand we can conquer it. It was true that it's not possible. So they, in their mind, felt, you sent us to figure out Alpiteva. So I'm coming back and telling my shlichas, the Teva, Alpiteva, I cannot do that. We will not be able to do it. So what was wrong? So the whole Shiloh, what was wrong with what they did? Why is it so terrible? They just came back and gave a report. Their Torah said is Bashtani, the mistake was in them. The fact that they added a maskonen, they added a decision what to do, saying they came to a decision based on what we saw. We came to a decision that you cannot go to Eretz Yisrael. That was the mistake. Meshe Rabbeinu didn't ask him whether to find out whether we are able to conquer Eretz Yisrael. Find out how it's easier to conquer Eretz Yisrael. But not asking them their opinion. They gave their opinion. They weren't asked for that. On the contrary, from them, and the fact that Meisha sent them to spy the land, to figure out how we could conquer Eretz Yisrael, that proves that they are able to conquer Eretz Yisrael even naturally. He said, to find out what's the best natural way. Obviously, you could they could conquer it naturally. But the only way they could enter Eretz Yisrael is by miracle. What's the purpose of sending spies? It's going to be a miracle anyway, so who cares what's going on there? A simon that Meisha told him that you could conquer it naturally and come back and just give us a report how it is. So it comes out as when they said we cannot go up, we cannot conquer it, is nit nora hisofe at the shlichas. Not only they added something that they weren't asked, they came and gave a report was going on, and there was a little thing that they added, which they shouldn't have. That the maskona is, the decision is that you can't. They gave their opinion. It's not only that. The nochmas is heipach hashlichus. It's against what they were sent. They were sent to figure out how to conquer it naturally, and they came back and said, we can't conquer it naturally. That's against the shlichus. So if they came with that mistake, it made them fall very low. In other words, what made them come to such a mistake is because they were told, use your seichel. But the seichel, using the seichel, was supposed to be based on the nase. Even though the Eibishter wants to, Yidin should do nase. And he wants that they should also do nishma. But it depends why you're going to do the nishma. And the Rebbe will say it soon. Why will you try to understand? See how it could happen. If you want to understand because you want to understand, so you're basing it on your seichel. That's no good. But if you want to understand because the Eibishter said try to understand, then you won't make a mistake. And they made that mistake. The whole question was, how could they fall so low from one extreme to the other? What happened in between that made it? This one nekuda that they went with seichel, and they were supposed to go with seichel, but they forgot that the seichel itself has to be based on the nas. Teir is meloshen eroa. Teir is come to the loshen of a lesson. Is a fun verstanding as in teir is eich faram de onvais in bitzu in sich zu bavaren of toa samaragam. So in teir we find a lesson how to make sure that you don't make the same mistake as the maragam. What's the data? What's the advice that he gives? So he says like this, the shem ha-seder in the meaning Yisrael is shlach. The name of the seder, the way it's meaning Yisrael is shlach. What does shlach mean? Send. Meloshen shlichas. From the loshen of shlichas. Which means, the Torah tells you, be a shliach. Which means, Ayid Arvis need us to know, as Eichman Epanem Sich Midar Aveda from Nishma, Kashtem Besichle, Ledai Techot. Even when you're involved in Aveda of trying to understand, that's the point you're holding it. Trying to understand with your intellect. Ledai Techot, according to your understanding. Therefore, you say the Gedenken as a tutas of shliach formation. You constantly have to realize, but what you're doing now is because you're a shliach of Meshe Rabbeinu. The reason you have to try to understand is not because you want to understand. That's what the Eibishter wants. When Demel, if the whole reason you're trying to understand is because only because you're a shliach of the one that sent you, Meshe Rabbeinu, giving over the rotzen of the Eibishter, is Demel is mavorn nit nor ben dem nase. Then you make sure that not only you'll stick to the nase, nor eich ben dem nishma, that when it comes to understand, you'll understand it the right way. This makes sure that your seichel will be the right seichel, the true seichel. It will come to the real, real decision that you're supposed to come. And he says this, the zach for seichel, he never explains it. The idea of seichel, the idea of intellect is, the real seichel is when you want to think about something, figure something out. The whole purpose is to figure out how the thing really is. No other side matters should matter. And you have to look at this. You want to figure out something, the truth of it. That's what seichel is. All your own personal things that you have in connection to this, you got to get rid of it. You have to put yourself to something, the idea you have to understand. Taking away, getting rid of all the side personal reasons you might have for one way or the other. If you're involved in seichel, because that is gives you good feeling, that's your geschmack, then it is recht and it's possible, as is if it's because of you, then your own personal inyonim could get involved. If you enjoy this inyon, you understand it this way, and that's what you enjoy, that's what you want, then it's very possible, if that's what you want, you will try to make the seichel fit to what is good for you. That's not really what seichel is. Seichel is to get to the point the way it is on its own. But those ain't from the biurim in the sheikh. That's one of the explanations in the problem of taking bribery. Teira says, as a sheikh and yavrei nechachomim, bribery makes the eyes of the chachomim blind. Yisalab dibre tzadikim, and it makes the words of tzadikim crooked. That's what it says. B'chura, the Rebbe says, I don't understand. Ibal, as teira says, is made as a tzadik v'ng chachomim tzadikim. The Torah calls them chachomim and tzaddikim. So the Torah testifies that we're talking about people who are really chachomim and really tzaddikim. Zayin zedo chachomim and tzaddikim amitim. So they're real chachomim and tzaddikim. And vi kumta zizol mechatchila nema sheichat. How could they take it? How could they take it? We always think sheichat means that you know it's wrong what you're going to say, but because the guy paid you some money, you're going to say that he's right. How could it be? A tzaddik would do that. I'm telling you, don't do it because it'll make your mind crooked. How could it be a tzaddik would even to begin to think to take sheikhah? No, the pshat is like this. It doesn't mean taking money or anything similar. And therefore you will lie because this guy paid you money and you know it's not true. You'll lie because you took sheikhah. That's not what sheikhah is. Sheikhah means you're not thinking about the fact the way it is in its own. Nor metracht wegen sich und der eigene Metzies. Think about yourself. Sheikha, your own Metzies is involved. So you're not thinking about the Metzies, but your Metzies. But then it came and it home, can I want to meet this in the Moscow? So if you get your Metzies, so you think about yourself, what's good for you, your mind, your brain will not work properly. Automatically, your brain will go towards that side, even though it's not true. So we're not talking about a person taking to lie. He's taking sheikha, planning to. It's if a person is a tzaddik or a good person, and he's taking sheikha, but he makes up his mind, I'm nevertheless going to look into it and paskan the right way, no matter what. But the guy gives you some money. It doesn't work. If he gave you the money, automatically your mind starts thinking that way, and that's not the real seichel. This was the mistake and the downfall of the Meraglim. They were missing the bitl to Moshe Rabbeinu. They didn't have the bitl when it came to the Nishma. Nasa they had. But the moment they gave them the mission of Nishma, they forgot that they're shluchim. If they would think that they would realize that they're shluchim, even when it comes to Nishma. So why do I want to see in Seichel and Derech HaTeva how we could conquer Eretz Yisrael? Because they Eretz wanted to see it. Then their mind would come to a real decision and they would never decide that we can't do it. And they would come to see how you could do it with Derech HaTeva. They wouldn't say Linuchal. They said we can't do it in Derech HaTeva. Because they didn't have the Nishma based on the Shlichas of being bottled to Moshe Rabbeinu. Now, in Order 27, the Rebbe asks, if we're talking about that, they were sent to come back with a report how they could conquer Derech HaTeva, because they could conquer it naturally, just they wanted to know how. So how come by Kolev, when Kolev contradicted them, Kolev said, Olei Nale, don't worry, we will go up. And Rashi says, Afilu b'shamayim, even if it means like going to Shemayim, we'll go there. Which seems to be saying, that it's going to be L'mayla Manateva. He says, don't worry, David Shtika could take us. Even if he says, go to Shemayim, we'll go. But here we're saying that the mission, what they were sent on a mission to see how they could conquer it naturally. So the Rebbe says here in the order, Hurak lifi divreye. He was telling them, according to you, shall be teva lenuchalal, you're saying we can. So he said, you know what? Lu yikid vireye. Even if you would be right, Oli nala, yuchal nichala will come up there. L'mayla Manateva. But that's like an additional thing. But really, we were sent to find out B'derech HaTeva. Because then you could understand it with your seichel. Ness is not something you understand the seichel. David Shekhar could do what he wants. David Shekhar could do it. But when we're standing up HaTeva, that's something the seichel could do. So when they went to seichel, they did not have the nishma based on the fact that they are shluchim v'meish rabbeinu. We balziam gefil zeir metzias. Since they felt their own metzias, therefore, when they saw these giants, threw a fear upon them. We felt like grasshoppers compared to these giants. So now that they got scared, because they got scared for them and see us, we won't be able to do it. This became bribery. That made their seichel turn the wrong way. Still they came and said, we can do it. It's all because they mixed in their metzias. When you remember that you're a shliach, and the shliach is the shliach of a person is like the person himself. In order 33, the Rebbe, in order 34, that means that a shliach hot nit kenegen the metzias, nor sein ganze metzias in metzias am shaleach. Shliach doesn't have his own metzias; his whole metzias is the one that sent him. And in order 34, the Rebbe says, like it says in Lekech Tev, Rabbi Yisav Engel, and the Rebbe brings it tens of times in the sichas. There are three levels in shlichas, but the real level of shlichas is that you become the mishaleich, you become the one that sent you. Your mitzias is lost. So if you remember that you're always a shliach, and you don't mix in your own personal mitzias, especially if you're a shliach from Meisha, and it says in Gemara that Meisha is the midas emes, so then you see the truth. You constantly stay tied to Meisha Rabbeinu, the Mishaleach, and to Midas Emes of Meisha. And you don't move away from it. And trach the ganze Zeit nicht wegen sich. The whole time you don't think about yourself, nor as me geht in Meisha Rabbeinu Shlichas. You're going Meisha Rabbeinu Shlichas. Then you will not be bribed. The type of bribery we said before, the moment your Metzias is involved, that's called bribery. It's you care about yourself. But if you always remember that you're not a Metzias, it's all the Shlichas of Meisha Rabbeinu. Then you fulfill the shlichas of spying the land. Spying the land means you put your seichel to it. So even when you put your seichel to it, you will do it bishleimus in the proper way, and you will come to the decision and say, the land is good, And you'll realize it even up the seichel, because the seichel itself is based on the nasa, based on the fact that the Eibishter wants it. But that could only be that way if you are completely bottled to the Meshaleah. Does bring the noch, this brings and keep Bishoros and Wilmisel, that you actually are able to conquer the land, and Rebbe is bringing it down to Gashmis, that we will be able to conquer the land of Eretz Yisrael. This some key ma'yid to fulfill the promise of Hashem, as Yarchev Hashem alakech, as Bruch Hashem will broaden the land, like it says, when Mashiach will come, we will get the land not only of the seven nations, but the land of 10 nations, three more, that Hashem will broaden the land. Keni Knizi v'kadmeni, and this will happen. Bias Mashiach tzidkenu, v'nheir b'yameinu mamash rabim, when Mashiach will come very, very soon in our days. All right.